In the next few lessons, we're going to talk about three different techniques for solving systems and finding out their solutions. What we're going to do in this lesson is solve them by graphing. So I'm going to draw some handmade graphs and remind you of something I said in the first one, that there are three different scenarios that can occur when you're using graphing. You can graph the two lines and get two completely different different lines, find the point of intersection, and that x comma y is the solution to the system because it is a shared solution. Something else that can happen is that the two lines could be parallel. If that's the case, then you have no solution because they have no common point. And finally, the two lines could turn out to really be the same line, and in that case you have infinite solutions. So one of those three things will happen in each one of our problems. When this is what occurs, you have to read this point of intersection carefully. And I'm a little bit concerned about my graphing ability with this software, and as I video, that I may not be as accurate as I will need to be. You're not going to have that trouble in my math lab because it actually draws the perfect lines for you. But you will have to read the point of intersection, like, is that the point -3, -1? So you'll have to read the ordered pair. But let's just see how it goes. All right. Now, I'm going to be graphing in this small coordinate plane. You can enlarge yours and you will get perfect graphs when you do it. Mine, of course, you've seen, won't be perfect. All right, when you graph these lines, you can use virtually any technique you want. You can make a t-chart, you can find intercepts, or you can use slope intercept. I think I'm going to practice a lot with slope intercept. So, first equation, x plus y is 4. If I'm going to use slope-intercept, I have to get it in y equals format. So I'm going to subtract x from both sides, and I get y is equal to negative x plus 4. For this line, I will begin at 4 on the y-axis. My slope is an implied negative 1. It needs a denominator, so I'll put it over 1, which will tell me to go down 1, right 1. So I will try to draw that, but please keep in mind that the tools I'm using with this videoing and on a tablet PC, they are less than perfect for graphing. All right, I will try to use a straight edge. All right, to graph that one, I begin at 4. And from there, I move down 1, right 1, down 1, right 1. Now, you notice that I'm doing down 1, right 1 a lot of times, and that's because I'm going to try to line up with my straight edge. You only can have 2 points in my math lab, so you definitely will just use the slope one time. Now, I'm doing the best I can to try to have, well, and that's a problem. Okay, still a problem, and I've lost all my points. My pen does not line up perfectly with where I need to do this, so please forgive me. Let's see if I can get it to line up. All right, that's about the best I can do. Right. Now the second line I will do in red. Second line is x minus y is 2. Once again, I need y isolated, so subtract x. Negative y is equal to negative x plus 2. Divide by the coefficient of y, which is a negative 1, and I end up with y is equal to negative over negative is positive implied 1x minus 2. I will begin at negative 2 on the y-axis. My slope, there's an implied 1 there. Give it a denominator of 1, which will be up 1, right 1. So begin at negative 2. There it is. And go up 1, right 1, up 1, right 1, up 1, right 1, up 1, right 1. And I was lucky. It actually sat on that other line. So now let me see if I can get this pin to line up, which I am sorry that it really isn't a very good lineup, but I will tell you that if I had done this as accurately as you can, that then you would read this ordered pair and it is 3, 1. So mine are not going to be perfect because it is very difficult for me to line these up. When you do it, you will click this and then you will fill in 3, 1 and you'll type it as an ordered pair with the parentheses and the comma. There will be a video about this, but to graph two different lines, you're going to click the line graph tool and then do where you start and a second point. Then you're going to hit the line graph tool a second time and do this, the second one. All right, let's see how the graphing goes with this one. All right, first of all, I have the line y equals negative 3x. Well, that's already in what we called slope-intercept form. The b value is an implied 0, so I will begin at 0 on the y-axis. The slope value, m, is negative 3 and needs a denominator, so I'll give it a 1. The numerator is the vertical change, so it's down 3. The denominator is the horizontal, so it's right 1. So I will begin at 0, and I will move from there down 3, right 1. Now that's, you would have clicked the line graph tool and done those two points. And that would constitute your first line. I'm going to try. You can't see my straight edge, but I do have a straight edge on my screen. All right. Decent. Kind of fat, though. The second line is 4x minus y is equal to 7. I'll subtract 4x, Negative y is equal to negative 4x plus 7. The coefficient of y needs to be a positive 1, so I'm going to divide every term by negative 1. Y is equal to negative divided by negative is positive 4x. Positive divided by negative is negative 7. I will begin this line at negative 7 on the y-axis. My slope will be 4. And it needs to be over a 1, so that's positive, and that's positive. So let's see what this one looks like. I begin at negative 7 on the y-axis. From there, I go up 1, 2, 3, 4, and over 1. Now, I'm fortunate that I actually intersected the line. And, whoops, my goodness, I have... All right, I had to pause the video because I completely went in the wrong spot by touching something on the screen with my straight edge. All right, let's see if I can get this line drawn. Oh, bad line. Nevertheless, I would have clicked the line draw tool, 2 points for the black line, click the line draw tool again, 2 points for the red line. If you could read this carefully, and I have... You know, I've done the best I could, but they do intersect at an ordered pair, and the ordered pair is, if you could read this carefully, it is the point 1, negative 3. it will be relatively easy to read in my math lab. It would be easy to read on a big grid with a nice sharp pencil. I'm a little bit handicapped here. All right, let's do some more. All right, the next one. I have y equals negative 2x plus 2. And it's in slope-intercept form. I'll begin at 2, and I will move negative 2, put it over 1. That's down 2, right 1. Okay, the b value is 2. From there, I go down 2, right 1. So there's my point. I do the best I can to draw that line. All right, the other line I'll do in red. I have y equals x minus 1. It's in slope-intercept form. The b value is negative 1. The slope is an implied 1. Put it over a 1. That's up 1, right 1. So here's my y-intercept at negative 1. I go up 1, right 1, and I hit the line. I'm not even grabbing a straight edge right now. I'm just going to draw that line. Well, that was actually better than any of the other ones I've done. It is relatively obvious that those two lines share a point at 1, 0. Okay? And you would be filling that in here. And you will type it as an ordered pair. All right, let's look at number 4. The first line, x plus y equals negative 5. I'm going to subtract x from both sides, and I have y is equal to negative x minus 5. I will begin at negative 5. My slope is an implied negative 1. Put that over 1. That's down 1. Right 1. So I begin at negative 5 on the y-axis. From there I go down 1, right 1. I'm drawing a few points, and I would get this line, which is not very straight, but you would get a perfect line. Alright, the next one, x plus y equals 1. Subtract x, and y is equal to negative x plus 1. The b value is 1. The slope is implied negative 1 over 1, down 1, right 1. So here's 1, and I would go down 1, right 1, and I could do that a few times, and hopefully you see that these two lines, sorry about that crookedness, but these, that's really bad. Those two lines are not going to intersect. Those are parallel lines. When they're parallel, remember that the answer to the solution is any point they have in common, and they don't have a point in common. So the choice would be C, there is no solution. But let me say one more time, when you do these, you get your information. Click the line graph tool. Click on the B value. Move with your mouse and click where the slope lands you. When you're through with that line, click on the line draw tool again. Click the new B value. Move according to the slope instructions. Click again. You will get both of them. And then you make a determination. I think it will ask you or check your graph for you before you give it an answer. All right. Let's see how number 5 works out. I've got negative 3x plus y is 1. Add 3x to both sides, and I get y is equal to 3x plus 1. My b value, I will begin at 1 on the y-axis. My slope is 3. I'll put it as 3 over 1, which is up 3, right 1. Okay, so let's see. Begin at 1, move up 1, 2, 3 over 1. 1, 2, 3 over 1. And I just did multiple points to try to get a little bit more accuracy. So I've given up on my straight edge. It was worse than my freehand lines, if there is such a thing. All right, my other line is y equals 4. What do we remember about that? It's a horizontal line. It cuts through the y axis at 4. So here's the y-axis at 4. I need just one more point along that horizontal line. Any of them would be fine. I get that. These two lines intersect right there at the point 1, 4. So my choice is this one, and I would put in 1, 4. You'll get lots and lots of practice graphing in this lesson. All right, last one. I have y plus 2x is equal to 5. So subtract 2x, and y is equal to negative 2x plus 5. I'll begin at 5, and I will move negative 2 over 1. That's down to right 1. Okay, so begin at 5, go down 1, 2, and right 1. Whoops, I lost it. 2, 1. Down 2, right 1. Okay, so I will get this line. My other equation is negative 4. X minus 2y is equal to negative 10. Add 4x to both sides. I have negative 2y is equal to 4x minus 10. Divide everything by negative 2. And y is equal to positive divided by negative is negative 2x. Negative divided by negative is positive 5. You're probably noticing that these two are the same line. And I get b is equal to 5, and the slope is equal to negative 2 over 1, down to right 1. Now, something I want to mention, you've got the first line. You probably recognize that at this point that you've got the same line again. You'd still have to click this a second time and go over it again. I know it seems silly that you can just tell what the answer is, but you have to have the computer draw the second line. Those were supposed to be the same line. Where do those two lines intersect? Well, they intersect at all of their points. They're the same line. There are infinitely many solutions. So remember, either they're going to intersect at a point, and you read the coordinates of the point, the x, y coordinates, or they're parallel, which means you get no solution, or they are the same line, and you get infinite solutions. That's what has to happen in every problem.